Much of your study time will be devoted to rehearsal and repetition of the information and skills that you need to remember. In this video, I intend providing you with some suggestions as to how to do this well. G'day, and welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graham Henderson. Broadly speaking, there are two kinds of things stored in long-term memory, facts and skills. Facts are stored in what researchers describe as declarative memory, and they require conscious processing in the frontal lobe of the brain. Once facts, the what and the why, have been introduced to your long-term memory, they're retained best if you can engage in what is called elaborative rehearsal of them. This means that each time you think of these things, you try to make more connections between them and other things that you already know. You do this by doing extra reading, solving extra problems, discussing them with other people, and being creative and analytical in the way that you think about the facts. For example, if you wish to remember Pythagoras' theorem better, you could find a book or two in the local library that had something to say about it, or go searching the internet for something interesting, or find a different textbook or past exam papers, or a puzzle book with different kinds of questions in it, or chat with your teacher or tutor about other ways of understanding or using the theorem. Or you could use it to do something interesting like erect a bridge over a creek or build a tower or some such thing. Be creative, but safe and have fun. This, by the way, is where nerds get up to mischief. You should be trying to develop new ways of looking at the same information and new ways of analysing the same situations. I actually like reading history and finding out how mathematics was used throughout history. This helps me learn about its connection with art and hygiene and food and discovery and explosives and medicine and so on. I think you get the idea. If you have found some interesting insights about any mathematical topic, feel free to share them on our Facebook page or in the comments section below this video. Suggestions are always welcome. The second part of the puzzle is how to deal with skills. Now, skills are stored in what researchers call procedural memory. This is where you remember how to do things that require a set of automatic steps. These include motor skills like walking, kicking balls, or swimming, or gymnastics, etc. When you see Olympic divers dive from the 10-meter tower, they're using procedural memory. They practice each skill until it can be done efficiently and almost without conscious thought. Some researchers describe this as moving skills from being reflective, that is, requiring thought, to reflexive, that is, not requiring conscious thought. All skills are perfected by rote rehearsal. That means lots of practice. A large part of all mathematical skills should be stored in procedural memory. In other words, you need to practice them until you can do them accurately and efficiently and speedily. Believe it or not, for a good mathematician, there is little conscious effort in solving a relatively complex linear equation involving fractions, because the skill has been practiced and refined. The key here is the same one that will apply to any skill that you want to master. It's not simply practice that makes perfect. All that practice really does is makes things permanent. The more accurate saying is that perfect practice makes things perfect. And so said Vince Lombardi, a very famous United States football coach. In other words, whenever and wherever and whatever you're practicing, try to do it properly and well without taking shortcuts or being sloppy about it. In mathematics, this means practicing setting your work out properly each time. Here are some rather practical suggestions about how to practice and rehearse your skills well. First of all, learn what is perfect first and practice that. Avoid practicing things you don't fully understand. All you're likely to do is succeed in making bad habits permanent, and then they're very hard to change. You should therefore listen very carefully in class and learn to set your work out clearly and in distinct steps or procedures. In other words, learn things properly in the first place. Correcting bad habits is difficult and it's demoralizing. Secondly, learn from an expert rather than on your own, unless you're very good at mathematics. This is why I don't agree with students learning their own method for solving arithmetic problems until they've been taught first to master a useful algorithm. They're then free to explore all kinds of other options. Unfortunately, many students learn bad habits without guidance. It's a bit like asking someone to learn to snow ski by going up the chairlift for the very first time and working it out on the way down the slope. It is much, much better to receive instruction and to learn your good habits early. The third thing is to remember that you need to understand, that is, have sense and meaning, and be motivated, that is, have value and relevance in order to learn well. And if you truly understand your work, you should be able to analyse new situations to see how to apply your current knowledge, and should be able to analyse your work to see where you could improve upon it. I hope these suggestions help you become more aware of how you learn and help you plan your study accordingly. If you would like to read more about how to learn mathematics, let me recommend How the Brain Learns Mathematics by David Sousa. You might ask your school librarian to obtain a copy for the library, purchase it from Amazon or the book depository, for example. The beginning of the book discusses the results of recent research into how the brain learns mathematics, and the remainder of the book discusses how teachers can use this information to better prepare lessons and to help students of different ages learn better. We have now concluded our three discussions about memory. In my next video, I'll share about six attitudes worth cultivating in order to improve the effectiveness of your study time. This is Graham Henderson, encouraging you to become familiar with your memory and encouraging you to learn how to learn. Please subscribe, like, or comment on this video. Thank you.